Well, here at Ferrari, they seem pretty content with the second row positions achieved by Felipe Massa and Kimi Raikkonen after all the problems that the team suffered at Monaco and in Montreal as well. But there's rumblings of discontent that they're not getting more out of Michael Schumacher's replacement, Kimi Raikkonen, the highest paid driver out there on the Formula One grid. Here's Louise on the problems of Kimi at the moment.
Ferrari's new darling slipped easily into his predecessor's shoes at the season opener in Melbourne. He was fast, he was fearless, and after an almost flawless performance, Kimi Raikkonen took full marks on his Ferrari debut. But it was a performance he struggled to repeat. More recently, it's been teammate Felipe Massa who's caught the attention of the Ferrari pit wall, whilst Kimi's championship hopes seem to be slipping away.
Kimi, don't let me go. When I'm losing my head, if the angels won't have me, or meet me at the barroom instead. Keep me, don't let me go. Keep me, don't you let me.
Of course, I didn't know at all how it's going to be. A new team, always a new challenge and new people, but I enjoy it. It's a nice people to work and everything works well.
We will admit that we haven't had a great start to the season. Certainly I think it's taken us a little bit of time to get used to him and what he needs in the car. It's probably taken him a little bit of time to come to grips with the change in tyres, and we've just had some bad luck.
And some people have questioned whether the inclusion of his old adversary amongst Ferrari's management team is as comforting for Kimi as it clearly is for Felipe Massa.
I haven't really spoke much with him. Of course, he's in the meetings and he looks to different stuff, but for sure it's not harming at all. So.
Michael is always experienced. I mean, one small thing he can say can be important just to think about and trying to see if really works or not.
You have to remember Felipe's been working with Michael for quite a few years, all the way back to when he was a test driver here. Whereas for all those years, Kimi was slugging it out with Michael, going head to head on the track and in championships. So there's a different history there, and that's bound to produce a different relationship now. And I think that relationship will change over time as well.
Raikkonen's always had his own unique style. He certainly isn't known for being a schmoozer.
So I cannot say he's a big friend of mine, but we have a good relationship. We work in a good direction.
But he does have a reputation for enjoying a trip to the boozer. So is that a distraction?
Well, I haven't been out drinking with him yet, so... But no, look, I don't think it's... Whatever he does in his own time, he does in his own time. And, you know, in some ways, the ability to really turn off and relax can be a strength in itself.
Here in Indy, he lines up fourth on the grid, and with a 21-point deficit to championship leader Lewis Hamilton, the Iceman needs to turn up the heat a bit if he's going to get back into the title hunt.
Well, Ferrari being very polite there, but Kimi is many things. He's an amazing raw talent, but maybe he's not quite the dedicated professional that Ferrari need at just the moment.
I think it's just a different character in Kimi Raikkonen, different to most drivers down the pit lane. But the car doesn't seem to suit his driving style, Steve. He's a driver who carries a lot of speed into the corner. The Ferrari doesn't look too comfortable. Massa's having problems with driving as well. But you do get the feeling if they could just get their car to be a little bit more composed, it would definitely be on the same pace as the McLarens.
What Ferrari need from Raikkonen at the moment is class and consistency, and that's been coming this weekend.